A while ago, Mikey Garcia said that he may, at some time in the future, be interested in stepping up to 147 pounds and taking on Errol Spence. Now, Errol Spence has responded to this week when he was questioned about that by a group of journalists, a group of reporters. And this is what Errol Spence had to say. He said that could happen. Mikey is a big name, has a great resume, and that fight could definitely happen. We fight on the same network, have the same manager. Why not make it happen? It could happen. He went on to say, it definitely could work out if he wins. Say if he wins, because Robert Easter, that's my guy. That's my friend. So I'm not saying Garcia is going to win. But if he does win, the fight could happen. I didn't challenge him. He challenged me. So I think the reaction would be positive. They'll probably praise him, because he's showing a lot of guts, a lot of heart for moving up to fight a so-called big welterweight. So, I mean, that'll be good. And then I'm fighting a guy with a great name and a great resume. And like I've been saying before, that's the type of people I want to fight. So I think they'll want that fight. I think that's a big fight. I think we could make that happen. Maybe LA, maybe San Antonio, maybe at the Barclays Center. Who knows? If he's a true champion, he's a true fighter, and he dares to be great, just to move up to fight somebody who's supposedly the most feared boxer in boxing, and he's moving up to take that challenge, he's basically daring to be great, daring to be a Hall of Famer and do something that, you know, a lot of fighters are not willing to do, especially in today's times. So kudos to him. Much respect to him for even mentioning that. But you know, like I said, a lot of people mention a lot of things. A lot of people say a lot of things. But once it's brought to you, you know what I'm saying? People rarely accept it or live by their words. So, I mean, he could be just blowing smoke. I don't know. If the fight is offered, I will take that fight, but we'll see. He could take a lot of punishment too from a bigger guy. So, I mean, I'm not going to say it's a no-lose situation for him, because you're going up fighting a bigger guy, a stronger guy, a guy who can punch with both hands and has a come forward style where basically I'm trying to punish my opponent. So it could hurt him in that aspect. I don't know. We've just got to see what happens with the Robert Easter fight, if he wins or not, and see what's going to go on. But I want to fight by the end of this year, hopefully. I'm sure he want to fight by the end of this year too, depending on how he do with Robert Easter. And you know, it could happen. So those are the words of Errol Spence. Some people don't like it when I read out the whole quote, but I just want to give you guys the lowdown this time around and the situation there. Errol Spence is looking to be in super fights. He's looking to be in big fights. He's looking to be in pay-per-view fights. And that's why he's interested in Mikey Garcia. I mean, Garcia has called his name. Garcia said it's a possibility. So Errol Spence has every right to respond to that. And he's interested in these mega fights. And you go look through the annals of boxing history, you'll see Marvin Hagler taking on smaller guy in Sugar Ray Leonard, who moved up. He also took on Thomas Hearns and Roberto Duran, you know, these all-time greats. Mikey Garcia is building a Hall of Fame resume, so he is the kind of smaller guy who could move up and be in legitimate fights against bigger guys. And when I say legitimate, it's not just any old smaller guy moving up. We're talking about a guy who is currently undefeated, a multi-weight world champion, moving up to try and claim a crown at a higher weight class. Obviously, Garcia gets more credit for taking that fight than Errol Spence would, rightly so. Yeah? But nonetheless, it would be a credible smaller man moving up to face Spence, not just any old smaller man. You know, that has to be said. So we'll see what happens here. We'll see how good Mikey Garcia proves to be in the long run. We'll see how good Errol Spence proves to be, because Spence has got a long way to go. He's got a lot to prove. He's only had one fight at truly world level, and that was against Kell Brook. You know, I mean, Lamont Peterson, okay, maybe, you know, world level slash fringe world level Lamont Peterson these days at welterweight. But in terms of the upper echelons of the welterweight division, Spence has only had one fight. And that was a tough fight against Kell Brook. It's not like he blew Kell Brook out of there. It was a tough fight. So Spencer's got a lot to prove. I think he can prove it because I think Spencer's just got a tremendous mentality. In fact, in a recent interview, Errol Spence downplayed his latest win. He knocked out his mandatory challenger in the first round, and Errol Spence basically said, "Well, I'm not getting gassed about it because I was supposed to do this to this guy. Yeah, he's my mandatory challenger, but nobody's ever heard of him. I was supposed to take him out early, and that's what I did. So I don't really, I'm not really going to get gassed about it." You see, that's why Errol Spence is as good as he is. That's why I think he's special. It's not because of his physical ability, because his physical ability is decent, but he's nothing spectacular. It's like Kelly Pavlik said. I saw an interview of Kelly Pavlik, who was ringside watching Errol Spence. And Kelly Pavlik said, "Yeah, Spence is not a massive puncher. He's not extremely fast or anything like that. There's nothing that jumps out of you about his physical attributes. It's more his mentality and his consistency, his single-mindedness, his toughness, and his technique, which make him so formidable. And obviously the body punching, which he's so famous for." So yeah, that's Errol Spence. He's open to a fight with Mikey Garcia. Let's see how it all plays out. It could be a good one for down the line. Let me know what you think in the comment section below, people. It's Atman, I'm out.